passage that Mr. Doug just read for us was from the Gospel of Matthew, and Jesus was speaking, and he said, he was talking about the eye of a needle. How big is the eye of a needle? Well, I just brought one so that you guys can see. Here's a needle, and that's pretty tiny, right? Can you see the eye? The eye is a hole that goes right through the needle. Can you see that tiny little hole? You can't even hardly see it. It's very tiny. And Jesus was talking about the eye of the needle. That's the eye. It kind of looks, it's shaped like an eye. It's kind of a hole. It's round like an eye. He was saying that eye of the needle. He's talking about that. What did he say about that eye? What did he say? It was that it would be harder for a rich man to get to heaven than for a camel to go through the eye of a needle. It says it's easier to get a camel through this needle hole. Well, I was going to bring a camel with me, but we couldn't get one. So instead, I thought I'd bring the next best thing, which is a stuffed animal camel. This is my stuffed animal camel, and it tells me how much it loves me. So when I get home from church every Sunday, I hug it, and it says, I love you, I love you, and I feel loved again. But now, Jesus said it's harder to fit a camel through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to go to heaven. It's easier for a rich man, it's easier to get this camel through here. Now, this is just a tiny little camel, isn't it? Do you know how big a real camel is? How big is a real camel? Show me with your hands. Yeah, it's too big, right? It's like a horse. But even trying to get this camel through the eye of a needle. Now Doug's going to help me. He didn't know I was going to ask him for help. Here's the needle. Don't drop it. There you go. Go ahead. Let's go. Got to get it through the eye. How many pastors does it take to get a camel through the eye of a needle? It's not going to work, is it? Are we just being silly? It's impossible, isn't it? And that's exactly what the disciples said. They said, Jesus, that's impossible. And do you remember what Jesus said? He said, yeah, it is impossible. But with God, anything is possible because God can do the impossible. So when Jesus said it's harder for a rich man to go to heaven than it is for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle, he was saying it was impossible for a rich man to go to heaven. It's impossible for a poor man to go to heaven too. It's impossible for children to go to heaven. Unless God makes it possible. God does the impossible. And that's why we get to go to heaven, because God loves us so much, He's willing to do the impossible in your life and in my life and forgive us, even though we don't deserve it, and love us all the way into heaven. God would do the impossible because He loves us just that much. What a good reason to thank Him. Should we do that? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for loving us so much that you would do the impossible to make it possible for us to come and live with you forever in your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.